Peach versus Daisy. Bit of a.
One of them is named Plum. Is that Cardamom?
No, that's definitely Caleb.
No, that's Cardamom.
Oh, that's Cardamom. Plum versus Poopy. Alright, so we got Peach versus Daisy. Establishing who's the better of the two Paisies here. We're gonna see them both once again start off with a turnip fall into immediate float. Yeah, I agree. That's why I play Peach. In that one week I played Peach.
One, that one goes...
No, red and white.
Red and white? You know what? That one's also good.
That one's hard. Alright, anyway.
I just like her colors way more than.
Dude, watching Paisy, two Paisies fight in the Ditto, it's like watching a bar fight in space, because they're just floating around hitting each other.
I hope they
Oh, hell yeah. You got double the chance of getting a bomb.
I guess that's true. Oh, guys, counter, but Cardamom didn't.
Throwing out the back here.
Cardamom at the lead, and
Oh, misses the.
Those turnips are good against certain matches.
You should just wear it on your head.
You know what? Fine. I don't really care about that.
Yeah.
Alright,
Oh, it's Blippo now! It's Blippo!
Oh my god, it's changed Blippo! Blippo mode!
Anyway, we're gonna see a lot of just floating around, landing with fairs and back airs, because that's a lot of what the Paisy Ditto is.
I feel like this would probably turn into some... Either tries to space out the other back airs, and the other person tries to go...
Yeah.
I think at this point, both kills.
Yeah, I wonder what the main kill confirm in the Paisy Ditto is. I wonder if it's like a turnip confirm.
I would assume it
or an edge guard.
Like just going for a air, catching out the
I would imagine Peach is one of the few characters who can also edge guard Peach because she's able to float. So like you can get in that dead space that Peach normally occupies that like makes it hard to edge guard her.
I feel like the problem is you have to deal with that has a hitbox on top.
But I feel like she can because you can just float underneath it, and then, like, because most characters can't occupy, like, the space where she's floating for as long.
Oh my god, that was.
Yeah.
Yantel almost killed their egg.
Ooh, good up air.
Maybe he'll go crazy with this.
Maybe.
He does have the opportunity.
Oh,
that was
cute little
shield.
Float cancel right in front of shield to try to bait on an option.
Right now, Caleb is doing his best to try and get this knock, and Cardamom is doing damage. Keeping him in play, you know, racking up that damage, because, you know, that's what...
I think a lot of what we're seeing here is a lot of up smashes, as you just saw there twice from both players. Because
yeah.
What, like, a lot of the...
I think they're just fishing for those really good to shoot after something happens.
Yeah, it's also just, as you, like, know, Peach is going to be want to be in the air, because they're going to want to be floating a lot. So because you're floating... The main anti-air is gonna be up smash to try to punish that to try to get a kill.
Yeah, I feel like the thing though is definitely bait that out from position. I feel like if whichever one like starts to go, Ashes probably be able to start looking at these types of problems.
I do see Caleb going a lot for the side B. I don't really know if I liked it a lot because he usually Peach definitely has the tools to punish that with like a float back air or a float up air out of shield.
Yeah, I feel like especially someone like Pete, definitely a little outspace it. And I feel like that's really the primary weakness. If it hits your shield, it's really strong. If you're managed to space it out where Gus right outside of his range and they go for it, you can definitely.
Yeah. Some characters like definitely can punish side B on shield, but
yeah,
like
it's definitely very harder, especially for your slower.
Yeah.
I think
hard call out on the float.
Yeah.
Good job.
I think Cardamom was drifting back. I don't think he expected it.
Yep.
Back so far there. But really good for Caleb. He's definitely.
That
was the momentum shift.
Building up this percent real quick.
Wow.
Oh, that was cute. That was so cool.
And
the little sub float into the Z drop into the grab. That was really cool. Yeah. He's a Peach enjoyer through and through. Exactly.
Yeah, he could probably be watching the most random.
Yeah. Some fucking dude from North Dakota versus one of his homeboys. As long as they play Peach.
North Dakota, we ride.
Yeah, he rides North Dakota. in that scenario. Oh, right. Little wait and shield there. Wondering if he was looking for an up smash if he tried
Caleb
to punish something. Oh. That dash attack. I think that dash attack has to be stale. That should be killing there 100%, especially with rage that Cardamom has.
Yeah. No, that was incredibly
the, no shot he's living that twice, but
there's less than 2 minutes left in this match. If people get a timeout.
Yeah, but as we know, Cardamom's not out of it yet.
Oh, that was a big S.
Peach definitely has the tools to make a huge comeback with combos that lead up really quickly, like straight to 60.
Oh,
ooh.
Good
bait. Yeah, so
and then he went for it. He knew at that point Cardamom doesn't have any other option. He either holds
So he floated like
Wait, is mine not working? It might not be.
It might just be that headset.
Yeah, it might just be that.
Wait,
headset.
Talk right now? Yeah, so you see how you're
yeah, it's not happening.
Your headset won, so
yeah, I know. Okay. Hey.
Shade. Anyway, what Azaz is talking about, the little float towards him, and then Z dropping the turn up into floating back and throwing out a side B to catch the aggressive option was just a really good bait right there. As we go into game two, I didn't see the stage pick. I'm assuming they ran it. Oh, no, they went to Hollow Bastion. I heard it. There you go. Alright, let me update the
Does
score.
This work now?
Yeah, you're good. I think, at least it's showing up in the thing.
Maybe it wasn't working again afterwards, because you couldn't hear me.
Yeah, Blippo, can we get confirmation in the chat?
Yeah, we'd really appreciate it.
As this?
I love you, Flair. What?
No idea.
Okay.
Do not
Right now, the Cardamom, trying his best to get back into this match. He had a huge lead in going into the first game. Especially at that second stock, but Caleb!
Good kill
confirmed. Wow, that was good. I was not expecting that. I don't think Cardamom was either.
Well, no, that's a confirm. It's a Peach, like, turn up into fair confirms, a lot of percents and ranges. It's actually pretty insane.
Yeah. I know a lot of people don't talk about this character as much, but I feel like they're still really good.
Oh, yeah, no, Peach is still amazing.
She's still broken.
Character.
Like, I feel like even though she got, slightly nerfed in, 3.1.0, I feel like she hasn't really seen, any significant changes, and a lot of the Peach mains have had a lot of time to work with the character.
The only thing she's missing is range. She has terrific... Oh, that's a Stitch Face.
Oh, shit, really? Oh, shit. And he threw it away.
Now, don't believe what Cardamom says to you, but this guy pulls, two Stitches a set. It's
bro,
insane.
Bro steals from Kroger's. Of course he gets fucking Stitch Faces all the time.
He's lucky as hell, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
Yep. He stole Dippin' Dots from King's Dominion. Bro is a certified criminal.
That he also told the bank dealer that he tried to,
he tried going for multiple back airs and got walled up by that down tilt. No kill, though. I really feel like the problem with both these players here is either of them are trying to find some of these kills, and whoever is the one who can... Oh, another stitch, and he threw it away! Oh, that could have been brutal. That could have been crucial.
Shouldn't kill?
Nah, it won't.
I think forward throw will kill now if he's at the ledge.
Nah, back throw would kill because I think around 150-ish it definitely kills.
I think
it was a lot stronger pre-patch though.
Isn't forward throw stronger than back throw?
No, I don't think so.
Or maybe the angle's
the angle's just weirder.
Yeah. Now Cardamom.
I think back throw is her only kill throw if I remember correctly, but maybe I'm not remembering. We could probably ask Cardamom afterwards.
Good confirm, quick 50%.
Wow.
Great way to convert off a Nair, and now Cardamom fighting on his last tournament stock.
Yeah.
And he's got a bit of a comeback to mount.
I feel like this is kind of the same thing we saw last time, but Caleb started off in the lead.
Yeah.
And now he's just controlling the end game. And I really feel like that's kind of Cardamom's issue here. He doesn't have the control. He doesn't have the neutral down as well. I feel like even with a character like Peach, you can get really good with her punish game, but if you can't win neutral once, you know, what's the point, you know?
Yeah. KML tournaments, shouts out, baby. What's going on? All right,
good back here, though. He could still bring himself back into this game, but he needs to make a major comeback.
Just like Hungry Box, he is in need of a major comeback. Cardamom going to be needing.
Oh, but he gets slammed by that side B.
In an edge guard position.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. And he waited for him, and it's over.
Good wait and punish there from
Caleb.
Wow,
good stuff from Caleb,
taking
though.
Taking this set 2-0.
You know, taking it over the VT resident Daisy main. Maybe we have a new challenger for Cardamom.